Hello and welcome to the SWM podcast.
Because you're in the car with me, I got really flustered about the name of my own podcast.
It is
Trinity Thriller, is what I'm calling this episode.
Okay.
Because I like alliteration. The one I did before in Rudy was named Rudy Invasion.
Okay.
So we're off to WrestleZone at the Trinity Centre today. Trinity Centre Takeover, I think we've called it. So this is Kelly's first show. She's driving, and I'll let her concentrate.
Please do.
Because we want to get
there
alive. We're running a tad late already, so I don't know how they're going to find this out, but if they could like hold off the first match a little bit, that'd be great. My beard looks wonderful in this video.
Look at you.
I know. Great. Don't make a joke about a beard, that's fine. So do a little vlog. Do a little vlog bonus. We do have some questions, which are actually, I'd have to come out of the video to go find them, but Ronan King asked, so I'll ask you it as well. He just asked simply, why does he always look gorgeous wherever he wrestles? So.
I don't know.
just luck, is it?
It's just luck, just I luck. Guess, yeah.
So this is your first show, kind of. I mean, it's a free show in the Trinity Centre, so I'm doubting it's going to be...
I'm dipping my toe back in.
I doubt it's going to be like story-based. There's going to be too much... like stuff that'll affect Halloween hijinks, but it's first show since the Rumble. The Rumble.
First show since our son was born.
It's first show, yeah. This will be my
Probably
second.
First show since our son was born.
Yeah. I don't want to put him with the blame why we're running a bit late, but he was being a bit more of a faff this morning than he usually is. So he needed a fed before we left, which is fair. He's a Strachan. That's what we do.
He's a bottomless pit.
He is.
Just like his dad.
Yeah, that's how we roll. So I'm in Halloween gear. This is a shirt that you'll probably see in an upcoming episode as well, because it's like, I've only got like two Halloween shirts, so.
Shocking.
This is the same one that I'm going to wear in an upcoming episode that'll come out.
Our baby's got more Halloween themed clothing than you do.
He has so much Halloween clothing. It's incredible. Not surprising. At all, in the slightest.
If you know me, it's not surprising in the slightest. If you don't know me, you might be a little bit confused right now.
I'm realising that I am very much a shaky, calm holder. I'm going to have to see if I can stabilise it later. The other question was, which it was a really long question, so I'm going to have to kind of paraphrase it so I remember what it was.
Okay.
It was Mickey Vago.
Okay.
The current WrestleZone Tri-Counties champion.
Yay!
He asked... will Blue Thunder be able to stop him from doing the Stone Cold beer can smash with Greg sausage rolls in the ring? Probably not. If he does it in the first match, then by the time we arrive, if we do miss the first one, if we see Blue Thunder looking absolutely...
If we see
Blue Thunder looking absolutely furious, either with Kiki tail and a mask, then we know that it's already happened. And
at least it's something edible.
I know, but he wouldn't want to eat it off the ring.
He can eat it off his face.
That's taking a dark turn already. oh, this corner that stinks, isn't it?
Yeah, it's
great. We'll leave it at that then. So yeah, really excited for Trinity Centre Takeover. Hopefully I'll get some, I'll do a montage. I'll probably do a montage of these little vlogs. Taking that from Brian Tucker, because it should be vlogs, and the vlog sounds cringier and funnier.
I think it does.
And then we'll do a little bit at the end, maybe, after we've suffered or faced with the TGIs.
I might be a little bit more brave by then, because, you know, I'll have had a cocktail or two.
Well, you'll have to hold the camera, because I'll be driving home.
Oh my god, it's going to be even more shaky then, isn't it?
It's going to be good fun, so. Right. I don't know what's going to come next. Might do a bit before the
see
montage,
the
but if not,
side.
See you on the flippy flop.
Let everyone know that we are Aberdeen and Northeast local.
Then it's your chance to be rude. Hey kid, don't ever let them get inside your head. They'll tell you what to do in life instead of everything you know that you could get. Let them guide your life towards regret. I'll fight for what I love with every breath. My past is filled with things I won't forget. I use them all to push me to my best. So treat the worst of times just like a test. If only I could go back in time, I'd tell myself that everything will end up alright. Just push yourself, test yourself, figure out what you like, and find your limits, don't be rigid, always work towards a prime. Surround yourself with open minds, people can change your life. A few friends with intent can help you feel alive. Find a passion, take some action, and with a little time, just be patient, make a statement, try to enjoy your life. They'll try to kick you while you're down. They wanna rise up while you drown. They wanna fill your head with doubt. They're silently scared that you'll figure it out. I'll make it look like I'm losing. Won't bother hiding my bruises. And when they finally think you're wounded, then it's your chance to be ruthless. And I swear I won't give back up, cause I don't deserve a thing, and the road ahead is tough. They'll try to kick you while you're down. They wanna rise up while you drown. They wanna fill your head with doubt. They're silently scared that you'll figure it out. I'll make it look like I'm losing. Won't bother hiding my bruises. And when they finally think you're wounded, then it's your chance to be ruthless.
That for a montage. Now back in the studio, the SWN Towers, for this closing segment. I've got a bunch of questions to answer, so we're going to get to it. But before I do that, it was a great day at Trinity Center for WrestleZone Trinity Center Takeover. I had a lot of fun. I missed some of the first hour. I saw pretty much the remaining bit of it, so I missed a couple of matches, but the full results are on the SWN website, swnscotland.com, and you can go see what happened throughout the day, because there's some matches that were on that show that you probably won't get to see at an event anytime soon. There was things like Omar Muhammad. He wasn't in matches that you won't see anytime soon. He was in a great tag team match, and I saw the tail end of his match with Zach Dynamite, which I would love to see playback. Got Omar on my mind because he was throwing out the Cacobras all over the place in the Battle Royal main event, and of course he got a picture, which you'll probably see somewhere in this episode, with Lightning McQueen. If it's not in the montage, stay tuned. It'll be somewhere in this episode. You just keep watching, you'll see it soon. Omar. I have Omar on my mind so much. That man. We had Zach Dynamite, Ronan King, and Conor Malloy in a great triple threat match over the Undisputed Championship. Conor got an injury quite early on, and so it was a lot of it was Zach Dynamite versus Ronan King, which again, as I said, it's not something you probably will see anytime soon. But who knows? We might see Ronan King going after a championship of some description We've got a great triple threat between Dino, Bruiser Brad Evans, and Mickey Vago. There'll be some clips in our episode or in our montage. It was hard hitting. It was just, they were just smashing each other for a good period. So it was a lot of fun. And we've got Battle Royal. I love a Battle Royal. We've got a lot of great tag team match with the Heavy Metal Hooligans reuniting. When we had Mickey Vago and Connor Malloy teaming up against Bruiser Brad and Ryan Riley with the Foundation. It was just a lot of fun. It was a really nice. And we've got Blue Thunder back in the ring briefly, teaming up with new face Tommy Raiden, who I spent the whole day trying to figure out what his last name was because I couldn't hear it. I thought it was Rain, which would have met my weather-based pun team name wonderfully if it was Tommy Rain and Blue Thunder. It wasn't to be. It was Tommy Raiden. But I just asked someone afterwards, just so I knew, so I could put it in the results, and so I could speak about him, because he had a lot of matches. He was trial by fire, if we're going to go by that, because he had so many matches throughout the day, and he looked knackered by the end of it. He had the Battle Royal, which again, there's clips on. He had a singles match, he had tag team matches. He was just all over the show. A good way to really dip his toe into the whole thing of this whole wrestling game. There were some really great moments. He did look a little bit new and fresh, which he is, so that you'd expect that anyway. But he had a really good showing overall. The crowd was good. There was just a constant crowd throughout the day. And like I said, I missed some of the first hour, but every time I came around between Primark visits, there was a good crowd, a loud crowd as well. They were all up for watching some wrestling. I was hearing some people about, was hearing parents with their kids, and the kids were absolutely buzzing. They were getting their t-shirts signed. They were getting little bits of paper signed and everything. Ronan was handing out, I think it was photos saying he should be the next British Prime Minister. I wouldn't know. I didn't get one because he ran out just before he got to me, and I was absolutely shocked and bereft. But we'll get onto that in a second because he did throw in a question. So we've got a bunch of questions, like I said, in this little end part of the vlog, of the Trinity Thriller vlog. So it'll be going out just as soon as possible, as soon as I've got it put onto the old file. It'll be shipped out, hopefully, to just this evening, which makes no difference. You don't know when I'm recording this, but I'm recording it on the Monday, so it'll probably go out Monday evening. So got Callum, we'll start with him, because he put in the questions first. Who impressed you the most? There's so many. I developed even more of a soft spot for Ryan Riley than I already do, because he was just great. Every time I saw him wrestling, any time I saw him ringside with the Foundation, he was just excellent. I do have a big soft spot for Ryan Riley. Who else? Ronan was absolutely deplorable. He was as you'd expect and hope he would be. But I'll get onto that in a bit when I get to his question. Just so many. I really liked Rhys Dawkins. I like Rhys Dawkins and Brian Tucker now that they're a team. Rhys has got Tartan Trues, which, love it. Absolutely love it. And Brian Tucker has got a bunnet, even better. I didn't think I could love anything more, but the fact that they're both wearing tartan trues. Rhys has got the green and blue. It's some sort of tartan. I don't know. It's not my area of expertise. But Brian's got his red and blue as well. It's just excellent. Love it. I love matching tag teams. I love teams that wear similar gear or similar enough to know that they're a team. So I see that was ace. Who else was Tommy? I said Tommy Raiden had a really good showing. Just because he was clearly knackered towards the end of the day, but he constantly kept going. He was always there. The crowd really enjoyed seeing him as well. The kids especially, they were all up for seeing Tommy Raiden every time he came through after his first couple matches. So that was a really great showing. I'm trying to think just who else. Foundation are always great. Connor's great. I've missed Dino Murphy, really good as well. Just everyone. I had a really good time. I said, I saw, well, I can't remember how many matches there were, but I missed two of them. And I had an absolute blast every time, every match. Just there was always something that showed you what WrestleZone's all about. And it really hammered home that you should be going to get tickets for Halloween Hijinks on the 29th. So it was a fantastic show. But just for that itself, it's free. It's always good, but it also meant that we got to advertise WrestleZone, and everyone seemed to be having a blast.
What do you see happen next in WrestleZone? Callum's asking. Well, it's Halloween Hijinks that's next, and I think that'll kick off. Not like it's not the road to Aberdeen Anarchy, but this is when things start merging, start forming, and the nucleus starts to begin. What we see at Halloween Hijinks, which I'll do a preview on the site this sometime this week. I'll do a written one. But there's so many great matches that are going to be on there. I want to see Ronan versus Grado. Oh, I can't wait for that. Can't wait for, of course, Aspen versus Zach. Tag team matches that are on the show. The pre-show match has been confirmed. I think I haven't actually checked the video that went out late last night. It's been a long weekend, so I just haven't checked it out. To pull back behind the curtain, I emptied the shed. So I was absolutely done, and I watched Doctor Who. So you know, I've had a weekend. So yeah, I think that's where we're going to see Halloween Hijinks on the 29th. If you haven't got tickets already, go get tickets, ringsideworld.com, and go get them, because it's going to be a good, the card's incredible. So the show's going to be great, and there's plenty that's going to be just on it. Oh, and when you say impressed you the most, Mickey Vago, because he was kind enough to get a picture with me. So, you know, he asked me what my name was, young man, and I told him it was Billy. And we got a little picture of Podcasters United. We just needed to get Kyle and Kayla, who weren't there, Fairweather fans themselves. Gallum's also asked, is Brian still a Wally? He's got a bunnet now. How much more of a Wally can you get at this stage? We'll find out at Halloween Hijinks, I'm sure, when he's against Scotty Swift. Ronan King asking, how happy were you to get that when you got to touch the glorious Ronan King's hand in the form of a handshake? Well, it was a great moment until you said to my wife, to Kelly, that with him winning the Undisputed Championship, sorry, that you winning the Undisputed Championship would look better than our newborn child. And Kelly is, I didn't think this whole like mama bear pride, like lion's pride thing was a thing, but she was furious with Ronan for the rest of the day. So any time that Connor or Zach or anyone in the Battle Royal at the end battered him, she was elated, including the bit at the end where everyone got a good dig in, as you just seen. Everyone got a good dig in, including Mikey doing the people's elbow at the end. She was absolutely buzzing to see it, because she was furious. She didn't expect to be furious, but she didn't think about this whole like I mama bear thing, but it's a thing apparently. If you disrespect our child, she might come and batter you. That's pretty much what we found out that weekend. Like I said, I didn't think it was a thing. She didn't think it was a thing, but as soon as Ronan said that, I found out it's a thing. Apparently, it's a thing. We know it's part of the show. We know that it's just part of the Ronan King experience. But yeah, it was just we couldn't believe it. It was just like she was just, even turned to me and went, I know it's not part. I know it's part of the show, but I am really angry. I'm really angry at Ronan King. So yeah, to see him get battered at the end, perfection. We've got loads of quick. Well, we'll go back and forth between Omar Muhammad and Ronan King. How happy were you when Ronan King got hit with a Pez dispenser signed by Omar Muhammad? Well, I didn't know it was signed by Omar Muhammad. That changes everything. I was really confused at first because I saw Omar where the boxes were. There was a bunch of boxes in the corner, and then it suddenly appeared with something in his hand. It took me a little bit time to realize what it was, and that's what you get when you do a good fun show, like a gala day or this kind of show, like Union Square shows as well. Was just a bit of a mess around and a bit of fun and something a bit different. But yeah, to see Ronan getting battered is always good. Ronan King, no one was happy to see a bunch of idiots team up and use illegal weapons to solve the best of all time. I mean, in a battle royal, weapons are legal, so we have that. Got more back and forth. What is better, entering a battle royal or getting photos with a Lightning McQueen amusement ride? Yes, that happened. As I said already, it did happen. We've got an angle of it on this montage. I've never seen joy. I've seen a lot of joyful faces at the wrestling. Not my own, of course, because then I'd have to be taking a selfie, and I have a face of a smacked arse when I'm getting a photo taken. But I've never seen anyone so happy getting a picture on a Lightning McQueen, like one of those 50p well, it's inflation, it's probably £2 now, rides, then I have seen Omar Mohamed. He looked so happy and so excited to be sitting there. And then to the point where he had to enter, him and Tommy Raiden had to enter the Battle Royal late because they were so concentrated getting this picture. Because me and Kelly were sitting on the ride, on the like the bunnet, not the same bunnet that Brian had, Scottish, you know, sorry. We're sitting on the bonnet of Lightning McQueen, and we politely got ushered off it so Omar could get a picture on Lightning McQueen. So yeah, go check his social media, or check, as I said, it'll be in this episode somewhere, for a different angle. You can see the happiness, the pure happiness of Omar on Lightning McQueen. Reese Dawkins asking, Reese Dawkins deserves a rematch against Mickey Vago for the Tri-Counties Championship, ensuring the belt has the proper cultural respect and prestige that William Shakespeare brings over his barbaric musical stylings. True or false? Well, I missed the match, so I am up for seeing it again. That's pretty much, so it'll go true. I mean, I'm not sure about ensuring the belt goes to yourself, but I certainly will want to see Mickey Vago against Reese Dawkins somewhere down the line. Whether it's Chaos, whether it's into Summerhill, I'm up for seeing it because I missed it, because I was too busy getting a Deadpool Christmas jumper. You know, the choices we have to make when we're just, yeah, it was a tough choice. I will say that, but yeah, I missed it, so I will want to see it. We did get a question on Instagram as well. I'm just going to go find it because it's quite a good question to end on. It's from, and let's see, I'll find it. Don't you worry, we don't edit out these things. From Ryan Riley. Speaking of Ryan Riley, the lovely man that he is, he asked, tag teams you'd like to see the foundation of the future face? That's quite a cool question to end on, because I was trying to think of a bunch of teams that I'd love to see the foundation face. And I know that in, I think in Discovery in November, they're going against the Odorous and the Fair City Saints. I'd love to see the Fair City Saints again up in WrestleZone anyway, because we've seen them in singles action, but we haven't seen them wrestle as a team yet up in WrestleZone. So, or I haven't anyway. So, I would love to see that as a team. I think I'd love to see them against Glasgow Grindhouse, Looking Sharp and Krieger. Brad and Krieger. Yeah, mouth watering just thinking about Bruiser Brad and Krieger just batting lumps out of each other. That would be amazing. Well, other teams have got them. We'll look at Scotland. That would be quite cool. See, it's always one of these questions where you have loads of ideas and then you hit record and you go, I cannot think of any tag teams ever. I like the look of this. I said it in my review of Discovery's show, most recent show. What was it called? Tagged. It was Untagged. I'd love to see them against Dickie Divers and Aspen Faith. They looked like a cool team of that brief second. It looks like they had a pretty good run in SWA over the weekend as well. So I would love to see that. I would love to see Brad and Gene Money like clash. I think Gene and Ryan would be really good as well. So Gene Money and someone, whether it's Martina or just get anyone with Gene Money and get them against the Foundation of the Future. And I'm just taking this as Ryan and Brad as the team. Can you throw in Zach there? You've got a plethora of teams across the globe, and I'm just thinking of really ones that compete in Scotland mainly, because that's more my wheelhouse of things. But no, there's just so many. I just want to see the Foundation of the Future wrestle. They're just so good. They're a great team. They're a really good cohesive unit. They look like a great team. They've got, like I said, they've got not matching gear, but they've got matching colours and the branding. They're just an excellent trio. Team, singles, whatever you want to do, they are just fantastic at it. And I want to see them continue to go from Discovery to go to Fair City and to go to other promotions and do more of the wrestling, because they're just ace. Give them against the Outfit as well. Again, just big lads fighting. I just want to see big lads fighting. That's my takeaway from all that. So yeah, I'll probably think of, once I stop hitting record, once I hit stop, I'll think of a bunch of other teams that I want to see them go up against. But yeah, Foundation, just get them wrestling everywhere. Get them booked if you're listening this far or watch this far in Trinity Thriller. Yeah, just go find some Foundation in the Future matches and watch them and enjoy them and just take them all in. So yeah, I think that's it. A bunch of questions answered. I think I answered all of them that I got through. I had an absolutely fantastic time at Trinity Centre for WrestleZone's Trinity Centre Takeover. If you haven't got tickets already for Halloween Hijinks, why not? Go get a ticket. It's up in the northeast. It's at Curl Aberdeen. I have no idea where that is. I'll be trusting Google Maps on the day to direct me. But yeah, I think that's a good way to round out. So thank you for watching this mini episode of the SWN podcast. We'll be back soon. I think the next episode that'll be coming out should be our Looking Sharp return. I'm hoping about an hour long. We'll talk about Dane Spotting mainly, a show that's coming up for Copenhagen Championship Wrestling at the end of the week. I think that's on the 29th as well. So we'll be speaking about that, but we'll catch up, answer some questions, etc., all that good stuff. And then after that, I'm hoping to have a Halloween Hijinks episode, just a mini one like this. And then we'll have the first interview I actually recorded for the season. That will be with Harmony Sky, coming out on October 31st. So there's a lot going on. The Hijinks one will probably be after that, actually, just for spacing. So we've got a lot going on, a lot happening again. I'm recording once a week. I'm gathering guests. And just keep a track on Twitter at ScottResNet, and you'll find out when episodes are coming, when who I'm interviewing, get some questions in, and all that good stuff. You can find out more at swnscotland.com. And thank you for people watching the Rise and Fall of ITV Celebrity Wrestling. That was a hell of a lot of fun to do. It's a bit rough around the edges, but I think it's just about 300 views, which is excellent. That's amazing. Thank you so much. I don't know if I'll do another one, like on another subject, but in my head I want to do one on five-star wrestling, but I think that's there's so much that I think other places like Cultaholics do something on it, or at least Matthew of Botchmania is. Anyway, other thoughts would be things like WOS, maybe something on WOS, maybe something on Hulk Hogan Celebrity Championship Wrestling. I don't know. It might be something down the line, but I tried it out and I wanted to just give it a go. I'm also trying things like I'm trying some commentary as well. It's basically content that I can make on my own, on my own time, and not having to like organize guests and things like that. It's just stuff I can do because, you know, parenthood and all that kind of stuff. I kind of work around Jack's schedule now, and that's just the way it is for a wee while anyway, until he's a bit more settled and sleeping, and I get a whole night's sleep. That'll be fun. I can't wait for that day. Anyway, yeah, thank you for continuing to support SWN, Scottish Wrestling Network. Go and please follow us on Twitter. Twitter is where you're finding most of the time anyway. Any questions, DM me. I am terrible at answering DMs. I will warn you that now, but I will get around to them eventually. And hope you all have a good day. So thank you. And thank you to WrestleZone for providing a fantastic, fun-filled show. Have a good one.
Thunder always comes after lightning. Kabow! Kabow!